Touch base. I'm gonna show you what I'm up to. And as time passes, everything
What's
changes.
Up, y'all? Oh shit!
YouTube is not. That was a video I was just recording and fucked up. You know how that goes. I'm gonna make a video and I'm gonna start making a lot of more videos. And this is just where I'm at right now. This is a beat I made on June 20th. Today's the 22nd, 2 days ago. So I wanted to touch base with everyone. I haven't made a lot of content, and that's really the problem with YouTube right now. It's not a lot of people making constant content, and it's because the engagement has decreased. So you might not get the same results with constant content, but it's really so important because we're constantly trying to go over the same thing so that we can improve. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a video right now. I'm just showing you what I'm up to. You know that I have the template. We don't just use the template exclusively to make beats. I use the template as a secondary tool. I pull it out of my pocket and I use it. And the template is something wonderful that I did. And I really hope to expand on it in the future. But really the truth is, to make the template, I had to have a strong foundation in Fruity Loops. And so here we are. Fruity Loops. So we're gonna go over this beat that I just made. This is how we make beats, or how I make beats nowadays. I make a simple 8-bar loop with fucking a whole bunch of sounds, and I put them all together like a smoothie. And then I just that's it, man. And then I start, you know, we can sequence it and separate it and mix it and blah blah blah. But we need to throw all the ingredients in. And so that's how I do it. Do it real quickly. Try to get you know, like if you were making a smoothie, you would just throw a bunch of bullshit in there and you push the blender button. And so this one starts with this one. It's a guitar. And I'm going to play this right here. Damn it. I have to turn this a fan. I got to turn it off. As you can see, this is a very simple melody made with a guitar, and you can see it right here. So we just made a simple guitar melody, real simple. And what we do, or what I do lately, is I take these guitar tracks, I send them to a guitarist. And hell, you can see how simple those notes are. Guitars will play those notes in about 2 minutes. And then he'll record it. And then that's about it. So we're taking MIDI guitar, we turn it to real guitar. It's about the same, but it's a big difference. So we're going to go ahead and play also a bass line, a sub bass. We'll turn it down for this reference. Also, I put a piano on there. This is like piano one. Just a few piano chords. Also, I put this piano. Is this it right here? I don't know. That much, it goes up. I don't know, but let me check that out. Alright, I brought it back low. I had it low before, I brought it high, but when it goes high, it sounds like a fucking guitar. It's not even piano sounding. It would be nice if I had it low. Just keep it where it is. It's I don't even know if it's too much because it blends in and it makes things muddy. But what's like this sound right here? It's another piano, a real nice one. All right, so that's like piano three. And then we made a few guitars, real simple guitars. So I'll just play like the original Omnisphere right here, the guitar, and then this lat guitar. And I think that's like a little prelude into the guitar section, which is like this. That's how it is. It's actually like guitar 1, 2. Let me see if I already linked these. Oh, I can't do that when the video's playing. But I didn't, so we're actually gonna rechange this. This one goes second. And this one goes first, right here. So I'm gonna rename this guitar 1. There was also something else I noticed, which was, we'll get to it. We also put a B4, so the organ's going with good sounds. And then I put this sound, which is, let me see what it is. Man, I can't hear it. Oh, there it is. Oh, shit. Fucked up something. I pushed a button. This video. Oh, there it goes. It's funny. Oh my god. Oh, there it goes. Damn, what was that? I didn't know I could do that. What is that? F9, F10? Nice. Alright, so the last sound I was playing up was this one. And again, it's just the piano. Alright, if I'm gonna have this piano, I will not have this piano too. One of these pianos, like this one, is just weak. And we don't need that. I'm gonna delete piano 2 by muting it. Fuck you. Alright. Hell. I'll make this black piano 2. There you go. Alright, so that'll be black piano 2. And those were all my sounds, so I went through the sounds one by one so that you could hear them. And then we put some drums, like real simple. We just went ahead and sequenced them in with the mouse. We can use machine, but there's a few problems with the machine. But it's not like we can't work around them, but sometimes I don't want to deal with issues. So I just jotted these down with the mouse real quickly. And what we're gonna do is I'm gonna show you how we sequence it. So basically this is what we do. I make a few sounds. Right now you can see that I have several. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And what we're gonna do, like this, we're gonna start naming these sounds. This is the bass. And this sound right here is the organ, the B4. We did rename that one guitar to lat guitar 2. I feel like something's wrong. Lat piano. We're gonna take this piano. Ugh. Alright. I don't like how it's taking up a channel. Alright, so see how we have these channels right here? We're gonna try to put the channels in order. So like if lat piano 3 was gonna be, it could be 20. And then this could be 21. But before we do that, we want to make sure that we didn't put anything on these channels, which we didn't. So 2021 through 24 is clear. So this one can be 20. This one can be 21. I'm going to go ahead and move this one that we're not using to the bottom. It could be 22, 23, and then 24. And if you look on the mixer, it's going up to 24. So I have 17 through 24 right here. That's what we'll do is we'll go ahead and link 17 through 24, which is 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So I'll just go ahead and I'll select these like this. I just held down Control and I used the left click button. It went ahead and highlighted those notes. I'll click on this mixer track. I'll right click it and go to select from this track. All right, all the channels are mixed to the mixer now. And now we'll go to my drum sounds. And as you can see, the drum sounds haven't been mixed to the mixer. So I'm going to link these real quick. I'm going to pause the video. I'm going to go smoke a blunt. I'm going to unpause the video. I'm going to come back. I'm going to show you how we just sequence the different parts of the beat right here. But before we do that, I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to link these. So these are all my drum sounds. You can see I have an open hi-hat. If you buy my template, and if you didn't buy my template, fuck, this is gonna... When I make a video, I can't push all my shortcuts. But as you can see, this is an open hi-hat. If I click on my mixer, I have an open hi-hat slot on number 10. So I'm gonna put this on 10. And there you go. I try to put these in order. I can hold down shift and I can use my mouse wheel to move them. So I know the hat goes right around, like, if I didn't have the video going, I could push a button and it would show me the mixer as I'm routing them. But we do have the video going, so. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and put my snares up here. And what I'm trying to do is trying to keep them all in order. So like if this was going to be a snare, you can see if I open up the mixer, I have snare 1, 2, 3. So I can put this first one on 3. And I can put this on 4 and 5. And I guess had to go is not actually 5. It would be 6. Oh my God. Basically, we want to link these two different channels, which is going horrible. All right, you can see this is the 808. I had the mono on. I'm going to turn that off so that it sounds original. And here's my hi-hat going through 6, but it needs to go through 7. And if it goes through 7, then that means the hi-hat is actually on 8. On 10. So what we're doing, so we're linking the channel. If I wasn't recording this video, I could push a button and it would show me what channel I'm linking it to. But the workaround is just to click the mixer button, open it up. On my template, we do have a channel where we can actually open the template up. But open hi-hat, you can see, is on 10. So what we want to do is we want to mix our channels to the correct channels. So all right, that's 10. I think after that comes crash, and then comes percussion starting at 11, if I'm correct. I'm going to verify that. Just look right here, click 11. 11 is actually crash, and then percussion 12, 13. So since these sounds are percussion, we'll go ahead and put them at 12, 13. As you can see, there is no crash. I could add one. But we went ahead and we just linked all our sounds. Thanks, John. Kind of mix these sounds, like the hi-hat's way too loud. I think some of the hi-hat, but it's not kicks were, I mean, a snare. These drum sounds. Usually what I'll do right now, since we've renamed all the sounds. Alright, so usually what I'll do now, since I renamed all the sounds and we linked them all to mixer tracks, took a long fucking 10 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to save it as a new version. I can push control in or I can go right here. It just made a new version of the beat so that the original has the original, and now the second one has all these edits that I've done right here. All right, so now that we have all the edits, they're basically all playing. We can kind of play them all together at one time. Oh, it sounds horrible. Which one is the guitar that I was supposed to delete? Can't remember. But it's all good. So we have lack panel 1, 2, 3. Then we have lack guitar 1, 2. And then this is the one. I don't know. Let me see something. Is wrong. I'm not sure what's going on, but let's check it out. It's the guitar is going to 22 and 23. If I go to 22 and 23, I still can't tell what's wrong. They're both like kind of lit up. All these should be on. Just funny. Could be this lag guitar one. Alright, once lag guitar one comes on, this is supposed to stop and just play this one. It's like it could be a buffer issue, which is, I don't know. Thank you. guess I see it. If you look, there's like these stupid ass notes right here. Alright, so I'm gonna push save and I'm gonna go ahead and stop the video. And so as you see, it took us 20 minutes and we were able to link all the sounds to mixer tracks. And they're all ready to go. One thing we can do right before I step outside is this. And go to these Omnisphere, really? And go to the sounds, right? And put a little EQ on them. All right. And that's only if they don't have it already. That's only if they don't have it already. So this one, like this one. So, you know, we would bring this until I started hearing it fucking up, and then I would bring it back. Right about there. Since this is the main sound, I'm putting on a lot of these. I've been putting the sound goodizer. It's actually weird. I just started using this just yesterday or today. But I was reading about it and what it does. It's just a compressor, and that's exactly what I need. I need a compressor that's not going crazy. I like how that actually sounds, so I'm gonna turn this down. Try to get it to match the original. Went ahead and turned it up a little bit, so I'll turn it down to the pitch. Alright, we got our bass. Turn it off. Go to our piano, just make sure it's EQ'd a little bit. Just like we did that sound goodizer, I'll put one on the piano. I was listening to this without the headphones. It sounds a big difference. Like, for example, I play just the piano by itself without it, and then with it, so it sounds good. It actually added a little volume, which sucks, but whatever. Alright. That shit is in key. That shit right there. Do not sound good. On this one, yeah, we're just gonna EQ it. I'm gonna go ahead to this one. That one, I'm gonna keep it like that. I'm not gonna do much EQ. Just on this one, turn down the volume a little bit. Wow, this shit is horrible. Alright, this room's getting dark. I can't even see the buttons on my keyboard. But we wanted to turn both of these down, so we'll do that. And then the B4. so we'll keep that just like that. And we did it. So I went through each sound. I gave it just a small EQ. Most of the time the EQ, it's just taking a little bit of the lows off, maybe turning up all the range. And there's a lot of different ways we could have did that, but we want to focus on removing the low, removing the mud from the sound. If a sound doesn't need a low range, then I'm going to take it out. All right, so we have our sounds here. I'm going to mute this one. It's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sounds, or 4, 5, 6. And that's the way we like to do it. We have our little drum sounds. They're real simple. And what we're going to do is I'm going to go ahead and sequence it out. To sequence it out, all we do is, instead of keeping the pattern right there, doing 5 bars or 4. Doing 4 bars and repeating, I can actually go right here, go to split by channel. And these are all my sounds split up. I can just hold down shift, go to the last sound, and then we can drag them out. And when we do drag them out, I can hold control, right click, it'll show me all my patterns. And as you can see, this one is a little short. I can bring the bar out like this to make it longer. So now we're just stacking these little blocks, Lego blocks. I'm gonna go ahead and pause the video. I'm gonna come back, and that's what we'll do. We sequence the sounds, take the drums, have an intro, have a chorus, and then also have a sequence of sounds. All right, let me pause it. All right, just went over a few things, just making sure everything's in place. So we just got the few melody sounds like this. We do have this 808 and some drums. I'm gonna turn those off. So that's it. So I just kind of made a little guitar melody, and what we'll do is get those hit those and also the B4 together. Yeah, I took that little hum out, and that was good. All right, so that's it, really. A lot of times on the Omnisphere sounds, sometimes you don't want to lose the preset. And so what I'll do is I'll open it up, and you can see that it's called Ocean. You just right-click it and then go to Save As. Copy that. I'll do like that and remember the patch name. Sometimes a plugin will reset itself, especially if it's been a long time or you're opening it on a new computer or been some changes or some time. Both the bass lines will play at the same time because we haven't began to sequence it, and we have them both sequenced out. And then at this point, we'll go ahead and sequence it. That's all, like I'm saying. You can turn all the sounds on. Let's sequence it. Whoa. You can turn the buffer up. Go much more than that. All right, I'm gonna mess with it for a moment. All right, and so we pretty much got this one where we wanted. Just kind of got the sounds going, and we got the guitar going. I'm going to let you hear the guitar part right here. And this is where the guitar plays. That it's a MIDI guitar that we play MIDI. I'll take off this bass, which could be too loud. Silent, we'll play a few guitar notes, kind of just like some freestyle notes. We'll have that same melody go twice, and we'll also have an intro. These could work together too, and we'll just kind of keep it like that. So basically, it's a rough draft, and that's what we want to do. We want to rework it, but we want to take different angles, and so sometimes we get different people to get a different approach on it. But I always want to lay down a nice reference. So I'm going to go ahead and end the video like this, and as you can see right here, this is the template, and if you click right here, you can open a machine. And once machine is open, machine is linked, we have I have a chain of perform effects. Or you can push a perform effects on the fly, record them. So you might be playing a melody and you could just put it through the perform effects, do some stutters or some echoes or some reverb. Also, it's also linked up to where all the drum sounds come inside of Fruity Loops. So if we're playing drums on machine, we can go ahead and link it on Fruity Loops. And we can add some of our EQs and different effects that we may have on our Fruity Loops EQ screen right here. So that's always good too. Also, we can also use machine exclusively. You can just go ahead and sequence right inside a machine. All the sounds are going to come through the mixer. If they're on both mixers, then we could use either mixer. I can mix it on here using the knobs, or I could just go ahead and mix it on Fruity Loops. You can see I don't even use those knobs. I could use those knobs right there. And also I can use these knobs. And there's a lot of different options. So once you integrate them good, you can you don't have to resort to one or the other. And that's the power of the template. It's not replacing anything. It's not going to keep you from doing anything. It would be pointless if the template kept you from doing something that you already doing. Only thing that it should do is add to your performance. So that's exactly what we do, and that's why the template is so it's hard to put it on the front line, you know, writing. It's really not important, because you should have a workflow and then incorporate the template into it. And sometimes we're using the template, sometimes we're not, but anytime that we're dealing exclusively with the machine, then you're gonna find yourself using it a lot more often. So I'm just going to go ahead and leave it at that. And this is the little beat that I made. And that's it.